Here we go, baby.
Good luck. Do not feel anyone else. We will be hand to hand after this hand.
That's a good start. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. We bluffed one too many times, Oliver. Three, 4.6, 5.6, 6.1, 6.6. We're up to 6.6, or down to 6.6, I guess. And yeah, feeling good. Could be worse. I was up to about 13. Man, trying to bluff the guy that never folds was not a good idea the first time, and then the exact same spot just came up on the river where it's like, oh, I got to the river at the bottom of my range and I have no bluffs in my range, and it's like, fucking, the first one's four to a flush, second one four to a straight, so I'm just like, lead the river, and he's like, snap call one pair, or snap call two pair. So crazy. So lesson learned, hero call me once, shame on you. Hero call me twice, shame on me. Oh man, I'll give you the one I just got owned on. So we opened jack four suited, the cutoff, which is like in the middle of our range. Button calls, it's this guy that's already here, called me once. Flops jack 9-6. We check call, he never bluffs, so I'm just like, oh, he'd bet half pot, so I'm already like hating it. Turn. turn a seven, I think. So lots of pairing straight draws in there. We check, he bets like 1.2, which is like half again. The thing is, like, the reason I felt like I couldn't fold is because he would also bet like 10s here or a nine. He just like really overvalues hands. So anyway, we call, at least I think he would. And then the river is an eight. So it's four to a straight, and it brings in the flop flush draw. And obviously we can't have any fucking bluffs here, and obviously we're never good here, so I led for 2 million. And the exact same thing, and he just like 5 second call me with jack six suited. He's been playing so tight pre as well, and then he just turns up jack six like a boss. So I mean, much love to him, much love to him. But gotta get him back. We're gonna get him back. That's gonna, woo, happen. So on the bubble, there's this guy that's been opening quite a lot. Not quite a lot, sorry. He's been opening like normal amount. But he's a recreational player that really cares about the money. And he opens the hijack. We three bet small blinds. We haven't done much three betting. We've done loads of opening and c-betting, stuff like that. So I think we can get some respect here. Although we do have a ludicrously aggro table image already. We three bet to like 1.2 or something from 320, maybe 1.1, I think. He calls after a long time. So we have 7-4 off, and it comes jack, jack, five, two hearts, we have no heart. We see bet 475, and the reason I see bet so small is because he's the kind of person that doesn't really pay attention to sizings. And I think he would, if he has a calling hand, he'll call a million. If he has or he'll call like 475k, and if he has a folding hand, he'll fold to both sizes. So we have bluffs, so we bet small. Turn, and he calls. Turn is a four of hearts, bringing a flush. That's where I have to start doing the speech play. Start being like, dude, it's a big pot. I just realized I'm near the bubble. I don't want a bubble. Have you got a 10? Have you got a flush? Something like that. And the reason I wanted to do that is because in these highly emotionally charged situations, people tend to go with their emotions more than logic. So me speaking like that, which I've done a lot throughout the day, just in different ways, that can either indicate a very strong hand to him or a very weak hand to him. Usually I wouldn't do it just because I've been speaking loads. I'd probably end up doing it for value versus him, but because it's the bubble, I think I thought he was just going to talk himself into it, that potentially being strong and him trying to lock up that 20K. He looks like he might be a satellite winner as well. So we bet like, I think 1.4, just waiting to shut down the river. And got, I think, like a minute and a half and then a fold. And he said, nice bluff. And I was like, yes. Yes, it was. And there, yeah, after that, we just took down pretty much the ante supplies every single hand until we bluffed it all off to that guy, the other guy. Solid. Oh shit.
No, God! No, God, please, no!
Yes!
You are fake news. Go ahead.
3.525, let's count it. Woo! I feel alive! Did you get it?
Yeah.
Yeah, boy. Arriba. Thanks for, dude, we're gonna make this vlog, like they're gonna sweat it with us. We're gonna call it like bubbled the main event, and then we're gonna fucking win it. So that was for 3.525, so now I'm up to 7.45. Some quick maths there. The mathematics of champions. Man, imagine how different I'd be speaking if I just lost. Obviously, the dream is to be able to bully the bubble, but maybe you can go a bit too far, open 100% of hands, and people start playing back against you because they're like, fuck this guy. So maybe there's a sweet middle spot that I'm still trying to find out myself. So at the beginning, everyone's like, fold, 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 he's probably got aces. And now they're like, 6-4, let's go, boy. So yeah, we're trying to slow it down now. Congratulations! Hold on, guys. Got it? Fuck yeah, dude. Made it. I'm kind of sad the day's over and the bubble's gone, but man, And this is my friend that was in the hand. I spoke about some hands we played.
Yeah,
we hit like 20 rounds of fighting.
Yeah.
All right, so let's just make sure this is a 20 in case that's embarrassing. 20. All right, so that's 6 million. 7.3 million. Plus 3.5 is 10.8, 11.8, 12.8, 13.8, 14.375. Sick. That's an all-time high of the tournament, boys. We somehow ended on the peak. That's pretty crazy. And congratulations to the whole field. Congratulations to this table. Tomorrow's gonna be a good day. Tomorrow's gonna be a fun day.